Good afternoon. I am Sritama Bose, faculty member of Department of Philosophy, Barakpur Ashwaguru Shivananda College. My topic is a very popular, that is suicide, a social fact. People often say that human life is sacred, so it is wrong to kill other person. Suicide has been chosen as subject among other subjects that which have had the purpose in our teaching career, since suicide is an individual action affecting individual only. Common people think that suicide is the consequences of insanity or a psychological fact. For a long time, it was not questioned that is suicide is a kind of psychological fact or another, because it seems to us as a psychological disease with its own characteristics. It may be said that every suicide is a madman. But today, this conclusion has been disputed. Emil Durkheim, he is a sociologist, define suicide as suicide is applicable in all cases of death resulting directly or indirectly from a positive or negative act of the victim himself or herself, which she or he knows will produce this result, because its features and different cause has led Durkheim to the conclusion that suicide is not a psychological fact, it is social fact. So Durkheim dismissed suicide as a monomania or a form of mental illness, because each society has a definite tendency for suicide. So he proposes to study it sociologically. Some people say that a priori there are two kind of extra social causes sufficiently general to have an influence on suicide. First, a normal psychological conditions like race and heredity, which directly leads people to commit suicide. Second, the nature of external physical environment or cosmic environment like climate and seasonal temperature have the same effect on suicide. Durkheim took up each in turn. First, most of the people admit that race and heredity are the conditions or the factor of suicide. According to this, it is a tendency to self-destruction which passes directly and wholly from parents to children. Even usually it's said that it is also assumed the racial characteristics are formed through evolution, that they are fixed in organism only through heredity. But Durkheim rejected on the ground that heredity and race cannot be a factor of suicide. He also argued about the Celtic region. The Celts belong to the Europe, like Ireland, Scotland, and some other countries. They have the particular race and heredity. But Durkheim rejected on the ground that it is true that suicide was common in the Celtic, but it is not due to a congenital characteristic of the race, but due to some other external causes. Even some people believe that cosmic environment such as climate and seasonal temperature are the factor which influence suicide. But Durkheim assumes that suicide can be flourish in any season, because suicide because this physical environment does not stimulate it properly. Above all, it has no effect on the progression of the suicide. It can be said that it is depend upon the intensity of the social life. After that, so how thus we admit the different causes of suicide? Durkheim directly turned to the various societies across which the variation of the suicide occurs and which within which their cause might be found. Durkheim finds out, first Durkheim asked the different religion confessions affect suicide. Catholic commit suicide less frequently, Protestants is higher in suicide rate, Jews are fewest in suicide rate than Catholic and Protestant. It is because among the Protestant, due to their spirit of free inquiry, Protestantism as it concedes the greater freedom of thought to the old individual because it has fewest collective common belief and practices. In any religious society upholds some collective sentiments or credo, but in Protestants such credo, lack of credo was found. They are less strongly integrated church, but Catholic are idealist. They have the belief, blind faith on the idea of God. Even they held together by strong collective credo, they practice greater morality and rigorous disciplines. They are strongly integrated to their society. Next, Jews. Jews are very much minority among the religious society. Because they are in greater union, they practice common sentiments, they have the spirit of knowledge or free inquiry, but not to replace their traditional belief with individual reflection, but they try to protect their religion from others' hostility through their superior knowledge. Thus, it achieved a higher degree of unity, solidarity, and integration. So, it is clear from the discussion that Durkheim rejected race, heredity and cosmic environment as the factor of a suicide. Next, he directly move on the societies where suicide occurs in different way. Secondly, he focused on domestic society because marriage has a preservative effect against suicide. That is why unmarried person are more prone to commit suicide. Familial bond can better unite married person. Husband and wife, belong to the family, not as husband wife, but as father and mother, as functionaries of the familial association. If the disappearance of one relation increases, the chances that other may commit suicide. Not because the bond that uniting them are personally broken, but because the family disturbance occurs and the shock of which the survivor undergoes. So it seems to us that family is the immunity of married person. When the familial solidarity weakened, the inclination to suicide increases. Thus, Durkheim admits that this immunity can increase with the density of family. In our Indian culture, joint family take very important part among members. In this kind of family, we can found the collective sentiments. Each individual conscience is accord in all others and reciprocally. Consequently, in a nuclear family, there a lack of conscience is found. Collective sentiments and memories cannot vary intense. They are less integrated. Small members of a family inevitably short-lived. That is why inclination to suicide is found in nuclear family. Consequently, in a nuclear family, collective sentiments and memories cannot be very intense. Lack of conscience is found. So, they are less powerfully integrated. Small families are also inevitably short-lived. That is why without any duration, no society can be found. So, it seems to us that in a nuclear family, inclination to suicide is found. So, it is clear from the above discussion that family is the safeguard against suicide. So, it is more constituted, the greater its protection. Another society is not yet discussed. Again, the as usual formula can be applied on political society. History tells us that suicide was rare in young society in the process of evolution, but increases when massive changes and cliques work. Like general great political changes, sometimes said to be increases the number of suicide, but some facts oppose that. In the time of French Revolution, the number of suicide declines. The great popular war rose, patriotism, national and political fact, even they force men to with close rank and against for the common cause. So it is clear from the above discussion that according to Durkheim, these three familial society has the power to prevent suicide. What will be the general conclusion? These three conclusions, like society varies inversely with the degree of integration of religion society, suicide varies inversely with the degree of integration of domestic society. Suicide varies inversely with the degree of integration of political society. These three proposition shows that whereas different societies have an influence upon suicide, it is due not to their special characteristics but to characteristics common to all. That is, they are all strongly integrated society. So the general conclusion is that society varies inversely with the degree of integration of the social group which the individual forms a part. That is why suicide is not a psychological fact, it is a purely a social fact. Thank you.